Hello guys and welcome to another video of Geometry Dash, another tutorial video. In this video I will show you how the stop trigger works, and this video won't be too long because there's not much to say to the stop trigger. All it has is this, the three standards: touch, spawn and multi, and a crop selection. And that's all for this trigger, what you can see at the moment. Maybe there will come more. Stop trigger comment help, and I prepared the movement, the following block here a little bit. You can see I marked them here. This is block one, a movement one, movement two and movement three. They all will just follow me. Just follow me here and they will kill me if I want to use this. So what can we do? We need to deactivate block two by moving, but I'm not just trying out something here just with some random numbers until this works correctly how it should. So we can just use the stop trigger. Now if you want to say okay movement, stop working, just put this in a group. Select the group here you want. This will, I think, only work for triggers. I'm not sure. It's wrong. It only works for triggers. This trigger is only for deactivating other triggers, so bam, just stay there. The block will immediately stops after hitting the trigger, and now we can pass this part. And if we want to stop like the green block too, we have to put this here. We have to select the movement free trigger. Or we have to add the grab 4 and the movement 3 trigger 2, and yeah, that's it, like here. Okay, you can make like an awesome part for this, so now every trigger should move. Minus 50 backwards, we don't need this one. Minus 50, because now it's this. We can make like an awesome maze. Like an awesome maze. We can make something to use the stop triggers. And yeah, let me prepare something for you and then show it to you. So I turned my tutorial level in a real tutorial level, so this is what I mean. You see three blocks here. The right one stops because we're passing this. But if we don't hit the key will disappear, the green block you see here. If we don't hit the key, if we hit the key, the green block stops too and will not hit me. Then you see the blue block, if you don't hit the key, the blue block will kill me. So we need to collect the keys, so because there are stop triggers to stop all the keys to get to the finish line. Because you see it, I placed here on some move triggers, some stop triggers, and they will stop this one, and this one, and this one. So you see, they're here to stop immediately triggers. So if you want something like a boss disappearing or something, or maybe a boss don't follow you anymore, just stop it. Just use a stop trigger to stop it. Let's find out what will happen if we're using a color change, a background color change. Let's say to red. Let's put this in grub. I did not try that out yet, so let's find it out. Okay, so it's interesting. So the color will stop. It won't turn red. It will stop there where the stop triggers. So this is something interesting I did not know. So we found something out together again. In this video. So this is awesome. Okay, so I This is like already it for this episode. I told you that won't be too long. Yeah. So short thing, this trigger only stops other triggers by putting them in a crop. Follow triggers, shake triggers, rotate triggers. I think you can disable, disable like toggle triggers too. And let me quickly show you something. I already installed this mechanic in Impact X by Nitro 451. So you see there the black orb? Okay, you could just jump down here. But this will kill you. I have to. But will point you an arrow on the black orb. And this means you have to hit the black orb to continue playing the level. And for a simple using of a touch trigger, let's quickly copy the level and show you. So you see, there is this not touch triggered stop trigger, and there is a touch trigger. The touch trigger, I will show you that later in another tutorial, reacts when you activate the trigger by just pressing it without touch triggering or touch triggered. This trigger will do something, activate, deactivate something if you touching while the trigger is active. So if you won't touch in that area, so by hitting the black orb, this bed up here will kill you. Because this trigger gets activated. No, it's not that one actually. No, fail of me. Grab ID 9. So the bed will be disabled. Let's scroll out. See, look at the bed. Look just at the bed. Bed. If we hit the touch trigger, the bed will disappear. But if we won't, the bed will fastly move and kill me. So that's one use I found in a level with the stop trigger. I think in the level master game there are many more of these stop triggers, but yeah, that's way too complicated. That's that level. I don't understand this level. So that's it for this video. It's already 8 minutes long. I never expect to show you 8 minutes something about this simple trigger. So thank you for watching. I think I will live stream tomorrow, but there will be a coming info video if I will stream. So thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.